Hi everyone, thanks for joining us today. Today we're going to be spending some time on the EM Test Autowave. This waveform generator provides a large library of test routines, lending itself well to automotive testing requirements. We'll go ahead and we'll begin the video by talking about the two different models of Autowaves. Then we'll move to the connections in the front and the back of the unit. And then finally, we'll go ahead and we'll start up the AutoWave.control software. Let's go ahead now and let's take a look at both Autowave models. Here you'll find the two different versions of the Autowave system. The more standard Autowave on the left and the AutoWave-WR on the right. The standard Autowave has two output channels and the AutoWave-WR has an additional two output channels totaling four and then two input channels for recording. The extra two channels are particularly important for some OEM requirements, typically when they're used with an external source, something like the EM Test AMP200N. Taking a look at both models of the Autowave, there's no external features that allow you to easily distinguish between the Autowave and the AutoWave-WR. The best way to do that is to look on the tag with the associated model number on the back of the unit. Let's go ahead now and let's take a closer look at the front of the unit. Here you'll find the front of our EM Test Autowave. Let's go ahead and let's start from the left side of the unit and work our way right. All the way on the left side, you will see a series of LEDs, the first of which is trigger, then running, and then finally power. To the right of that, you'll see a series of push buttons, and just above those push buttons, you will see the display. Continuing right, we have our active output LEDs, input channel LEDs, and then our measuring inputs. As we mentioned earlier, the LEDs and connections will be the same on both models, with only the WR models having the added capabilities. Let's go ahead now and let's take a look at the backside of the unit. Here you'll find the back of the EM Test Autowave. Starting from the left of the unit, we have our output channels. You can see we have output channels 1, 2, 3, and then 4. Just to the right of those output channels, we have our frame bus in and frame bus out connectors. Working our way right, we have our trigger connections, and then below those connectors, we have our CAN, Ethernet, and USB ports. Finally, just to the right of those, we have our output monitoring connections, and then all the way on the right, we have our DC input and power switch. And then just below those, we have our fuses and our power mains input. Let's go ahead now and let's connect our Autowave to our computer and let's take a look at the AutoWave.control software. All right, here you'll see the starting screen for the AutoWave.control software. We're not going to walk through all the different capabilities of the software today. However, just go over some of the most commonly used features. You can always reference the user manual for additional information if needed. The first thing we're going to want to do is ensure we have the right equipment added to our software. To do that, click the setup in the upper left-hand corner and scroll down to device. This menu is going to allow you to add, remove, and modify the equipment that is used with the AutoWave.control software. You can either select a system configuration, which you'll see there in the upper right-hand corner, or add a device individually. Right now, we just have our Autowave set up, so we should be good to go. However, for more information on adding different equipment and getting the communication set up, go ahead and check out some of the other videos we made on the EM Test systems, and I'll put a link in the description below for those videos. So let's go ahead now and let's click OK. All right, so today we're interested in single channel play. However, if you look along the top, we have play, record, as well as play and record. And again, as we mentioned throughout this video, if you don't have a WR version, you will have some of those features. Let's go ahead now and let's take a look at the single channel play. All right, so there's a few areas that are going to be commonly used in this menu. The first is the segment. And you can see that it's in that create new wave box. and that's going to allow for custom waveforms and tests to be created. The second is the standards test from the load or input section below that. This is going to be the pre-programmed standards, which we'll be looking at today. Let's go ahead and let's click on the standard tests. As we mentioned in the opening of this video, this waveform generator is commonly used for automotive immunity applications. So let's go ahead and let's see what tests are available. All right, so you can see right there we have international and manufacturer tests. Let's go ahead and take a look at the international options. All right, excellent. So you can see right there, we have many of the most common international requirements from ISO and SAE, as well as a few others in there as well. Let's go ahead now and let's take a quick look at the manufacturer options. Here's the complete list you can see, and there's many different options available there from Audi, BMW, Honda, and many, many others. Let's go ahead now and let's go back to the international. Let's take a look at the ISO series of tests. And let's go ahead and let's look at ISO 16750-2. Here you'll find the waveform menu for the superimposed alternating voltage test for ISO 16750-2. The waveform is specific for this test. However, the menu setups will be generally consistent regardless of the waveform or test that's selected. Taking a look on the left side of our screen right now, we have the waveforms which are shown, as well as the option to add additional waveforms or remove them. And you can see right above our two sine sweeps, we have a DC, ramp, square, triangle, and a few other options there as well. What you will notice is that the active waveform is highlighted gray. So you can see right now, we have our first sine sweep selected. Working our way right, you'll see the largest segment section, and you can see we have both our sine sweeps indicated right there, with the active one being indicated with a gray background. Looking just below the waveforms, you will see the criteria section, and this is where the different criteria for the associated selected waveform can be modified or changed. So let's go ahead now and let's decrease that V1 to 13. All right, and let's increase our VP1 to 2.5. And just as you can see, which is going on right now, those changes are made in real time. So you'll see those criteria when you modify them, change on the display, kind of in the center of the screen right there. Looking all the way at the bottom of the screen, we have our start, stop, and brake. All right, that should just about wrap up the AutoWave.control software. For additional information, please go out there and reference the user manual.
We appreciate everyone's time as we've walked through a little bit about the EM Test AutoWave. We started by walking through the connections on the front and the back of the unit, then to the different models, and then finally, a brief introduction to the AutoWave.control software. We appreciate everyone's time, and please keep us in mind if you're ever in need of any rental EM Test automotive test equipment.